Hi guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I am going to share with you how to crochet this small size emnoid seashell. So to make this, I have used single crochet stitches, half double crochet stitches and double crochet stitches and did total 14 round to get this size. This is 2.5 inch. In length. You can use this seashells in any of your crochet decoration. So before we start to make this emnoid seashell, I would request you, if you are watching my channel first time, please subscribe to my channel so you get to know my more creation and ideas with crochet. So let's see how we are going to crochet this emnoid seashell. To make this, I am going to use this embroidery thread. I have this thread, so I am going to use this. But you can make this shell with any thread of your choice. This is number 25 and 8 meter. For this embroidery thread, I am going to use crochet hook of size 1.6 mm. You will need needle and scissor and one stitch marker. So first, we are going to make this center circle. So we are going to make two circles, one for the left side and one for the right side. So to make that, take your thread and make a ring. Here I am going to use a magic ring. So once you have a ring, in this ring we are going to make six single crochet stitches. So take your hook into that ring, grab and pull the thread, make one single crochet, then second. So like this, make total six single crochets. So once you have a 6 stitches, if you are working on that magic ring, just pull this loose end. And one is done. Now take your hook on top of first stitch here and make one single crochet. Then on next stitch, make two single crochets. Then in next stitch, make one single crochet. Then on next stitch, make two single crochets. Then on next stitch, make one single crochet. And on next stitch, make two single crochet. So now we have 9 stitches. Now take your hook top of first stitch and make one slip stitch. Now just pull and cut the thread and secure this thread. Now just repeat round number 1 and 2. In round number 1, make 6 single crochets. In round number 2, make 1 single crochet, then 2, and repeat till your last stitch. So at the end of round number 2, you will have 9 stitches, and make, by repeating this stitches, make one more circle. So I'm done with the second circle. Now we are going to join these two circles together. So to join them, just make chain 3, after chain 3, take this first circle. So this is the front side and this is the back side. So keep the back side facing you. Now insert your hook from front to back. So don't insert the hook like this. we are going to insert our crochet hook from front to back like this. Now grab the thread and make one slip stitch. So by that this two circle got joined. Now make chain one. Now we are going to start our rounds. So you just skip your turning chain and slip stitch. Now we have three chain stitches and we are going to work in back loop of this stitch. So you can see this chain has a V shape like this. So this is the front loop and this is the back loop. So we are going to work on back loop of these stitches. So take your hook in the back loop of first chain. Here we are going to make two single crochet, one more in same back loop, so two. Here we increased one stitch by making two single crochets. Now take your hook in the back loop of next chain stitch. Make one single crochet and take your hook on your last chain stitch. And here we are going to make two single crochets. So we have increased one stitches at the beginning of these stitches from both the side, and now we have total five stitches. Now take your hook. So we come to the left side. So when you join your stitches to the left side circle, insert your hook from back to front like this and make one slip stitch. So we made our round number 1. Now make chain 1, turn your work. Now skip this turning chain and slip a stitch. So skip this 2 stitches. Now we are going to work in our next 5 stitch. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5th. Now take your hook in the back loop of first stitch. Yeah, and make 2 single crochets, 1, 2. Now work in back loop of next 1, 2 and 3 stitches and make 1 1/2 double crochet. So 3 half double crochet. Now take your hook in the back loop of last stitch here and make 2 single crochets. So now we have 7 stitches. And now we come to the right side circle. So here every time when you come to the right side circle and you need to join these stitches, you always have to work to the right side stitches, not to the left side stitches, and insert your hook from front to back. So this is my next stitch. So insert it from front to back like this, not like this. Yeah, and make one slip stitch to join. Now make chain 1, turn your work. Now in round number 3 we are going to give this texture to our work. So skip this turning chain and slip stitch, and now we are going to work in next 7 stitches. Now again we are going to work all stitches in back loop. So insert your hook the back loop of first stitch, make one single crochet. Then on next stitch, make one half double crochet. Then work in the back loop of next 1, 2, and 3 stitches and make one double crochets. Three double crochets. Now work on next stitch, work on back loop, make one half double crochet. Then work on back loop of next stitch, make one single crochet. Now again we have 7 stitches. Now we come to the left side circle. So here insert your hook from back to front like this. Make one slip stitch to join this row. So you can see we get this rib structure. Now make chain 1, turn your work. Now in round number 4, skip this turning chain and slip a stitch. Now we are going to work in next 7 stitches. So take your hook on back loop of first stitch, make 2 single crochets. Here we are increasing stitches, so we increase by 1. Then work in next 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 stitches and make one half double crochets. So 5 half double crochets, and on your last stitch to the right side, here make 2 single crochets, 1 and 2. So you can see here we have increased 1 stitches to both the ends. Now again we come to the right side circle. So here take your hook from front to back and make 1 slip stitch to join. Now make chain 1. So in at the end of round number 4 we have 9 stitches. Now in round number 5 skip turning chain and slip a stitch. Now we are going to work in next 9 stitches and going to work in back loop. So take your hook in the back loop of first stitch, make 1 single crochet. Then take your hook in the back loop of next stitch, make 1 half double crochet. Then work in the back loop of next 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 stitches and make 1 double crochets. After 5 double crochet, work in next stitch, make 1 half double crochet. Then work in next stitch, make 1 single crochet. So we made 9 stitches. Now take your hook from back to front and make 1 slip stitch. So row number 5 is done and we made our second rib with 9 stitches. Now in round number 6, make chain 1, turn your work. Now skip this turning chain and slip a stitch. Now we are going to work in next 9 stitches. Take your hook, the back loop of first stitch and make 2 single crochets. Then work in the back loop of next 7 stitches and make 1 half double crochet. So 7 half double crochets. Now work the back loop of next stitch and here make 2 single crochets. Again we come to the right side, so take your hook from front to back and make 1 slip stitch. Now make chain 1, turn your work. Now in round number 7, skip turning chain and slip stitch. Now we are going to work in next 11 stitches. Take your hook in the back loop of first stitch, make 1 single crochet, then in next stitch work on back loop, make 1 half double crochet, now work in next 7 stitches and work in back loop and make 1 double crochet. So 7 double crochets. Now work the back loop of next stitch and make 1 half double crochet, then work on your last stitch, work on back loop and make 1 single crochet. So at the end of round number 7 we have 11 stitches. Now we come to this circle, so work on next stitch, take your hook from front back to front and make 1 slip stitch. Now make chain 1, turn your work. So you can see we get our third rib structure like this. Now in round number 8, skip your turning chain and slip stitch. Now we are going to work in next 11 stitches. So take your hook in the back loop of first stitch, here make 2 single crochets. So we increased 1 stitch here. Now work in next 9 stitches and make 1 half double crochet. So 9 half double crochets, then work on your last stitch, work in back loop and make 2 single crochets. So at the end of round number 8 we have 13 stitches. Now make chain 1. Now in round number 9, skip this turning chain and slip stitch. Now we are going to work in next 13 stitches. So take a hook in the back loop of first stitch, make 1 single crochet, then in next stitch work on back loop, make 1 half double crochet, then work in next 9 stitches, work on back loop and make 1 double crochet. After 9 double crochets, work on next stitch, make one half double crochet, then work on next stitch, work on back loop and make one single crochet. So at the end of round number 9 we have 13 stitches and we get our fourth rib. Make chain 1, turn your work. Now skip turning chain and slip a stitch. Now we are going to work in next 13 stitches. So work in the back loop of first stitch, make 2 single crochets. Then work in next 11 stitches and make 1 half double crochet. So after 11 half double crochet, next stitch, work on back loop and make 2 single crochets. So at the end of round number 10, we have 15 stitches. Now take your hook from front to back and make 1 slip stitch. Now make chain 1. Turn your work. So you can see we get this structure like this. Now in round number 11, skip turning chain and slip a stitch. Now we are going to work in next 15 stitches. So take your hook, the back loop of first stitch, make 1 single crochet, then in next 1 half double crochet. Then in next 11 stitches, make 1 double crochet. So after 11 double crochets, now take a hook in next stitch and here make 1 half double crochet, then work in back loop of next stitch and make 1 single crochet. At the end of round number 11 we have 15 stitches. Now take your hook top of next stitch of this circle from back to front and make 1 slip stitch. Now make chain 1. Now in round number 12, turn your work, skip turning chain and slip stitch. Now we are going to work in next 15 stitches. So work in back loop of first stitch, make 2 single crochets. Then work in next 13 stitches, work in back loop and make 1 half double crochet. After 13 half double crochets, work on back loop of next stitch, make 2 single crochets. Now at the end of round number 12, we have 17 stitches. Now take your hook from front to back on next stitch of this circle and make one slip stitch. Now make chain 1. Turn your work and round number 13, skip turning chain and slip stitch. Now we are going to work in next 17 stitches. So work in first stitch, work on back loop, make one single crochet, then one half double crochet, then work in next 13 stitches, work on back loop and make one double crochet. So after 13 double crochets, work on next stitch, make one half double crochet, then in next stitch one single crochet. So round number 13 is done and we have 17 stitches. Now take your hook top of next stitch and make one slip stitch here. Now make chain 1. And this is our last round. So skip turning chain and slip a stitch. Now we are going to work in next 17 stitches. Work in back loop and make 2 single crochets. Work in next 15 stitches and make one half double crochet. After 15 half double crochet, work on next stitch. Here make 2 single crochets. Now take your hook top of next stitch here. Make one slip stitch to join. Now take your hook top of next stitch here, make one slip stitch. Now just pull this thread and cut with some margin. So this small emnoid shell is done. I hope you have learned from this video. If you have any questions or query, please do let me know in comment section. So see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care.